Hey there! In this video, we'll show you how to turn any zero block into a popup on Tilda. Suppose you need a personalized popup and solutions offered in the library do not suit you well. For instance, you want to design a fullscreen menu like this one, a halfscreen menu, a custom second level menu, a branded tooltip, and many other things. You can easily do this with the new T1093 block, zero block and popup, from the other category. Let me show you how you can turn a zero block into a popup and what you can configure in the block settings. Let's go to Tilda. Add a zero block to the page and create a design for the block to be used as a popup. Add the T1093 modifier block from the other category to the page. It will turn this block into a popup. In the content tab of this block, specify the ID of the zero block to be used as a popup. Find the zero block ID in its settings tab. Alternatively, click Choose Zero Block, select the block you need, and click the Save and Close button. Now you need to specify the link that will open the popup. This field is already filled in with a default link, but you can customize it maintaining the format as follows: hash plus letters with no spaces. Numbers are also supported. For instance, you can name the link hash menu 1. I'll keep the default link and copy it here. Now I need to choose the element on the page that will be used as a trigger to open the popup. This can be a button or any element that can include a link. Paste the popup link we just copied under URL. Let's check it out. Perfect, it works. If you want the popup to open right after page loading, select the relevant checkbox Open popup after page loading in the Settings tab of the modifier block. Let's look at what else you can configure in the popup. In the block settings, you can adjust what the popup looks like. Set the background blur and background color, modify the color of the close icon, or hide it if your design features a personalized button. I'll show you how to modify it in a moment. Now let's start with animating the popup. The first thing I want to configure is how the block will appear. It can simply fade in or pop out from the top, bottom, or from the side. I'll select appear from the right. You can separately adjust how the block appears on mobile devices. So let me set it in a way that the popup appears from the top of the page. Animation easing allows you to choose the speed and smoothness. I'll select Word is in out. This means that the appearance of the menu will accelerate smoothly at the beginning and slow down at the end of the effect. The movement will look natural: acceleration, moving, and stopping. Okay, now let's specify the appear animation speed. I'll set it to 0.6 seconds. Let's check what we've created. The menu appears from the right side smoothly by clicking on the button. But now I have two buttons to close the popup. The first one that I added and the default button from the block. Let me show you how you can use your own button. As I've mentioned, you can hide the close icon in the settings, so let's do it. Now we need to specify a link for our close button. In the content tab of the modifier block, you can find this link on a light blue panel, hash close popup. I'll copy it and open the zero block with the menu. Here, I select the custom close icon and paste the link in the URL field. Let's publish the changes and check it out. Nice, it worked. Now only the custom close icon is left, and it does its job. We've just configured the full screen menu, but what if you need a half screen pop-up? I have pre-designed such a menu in the zero block. To begin with, let's remove the background color by deleting the value in the BG color field. You can adjust the width and height of the pop-up in the zero block settings. For example, I've used paddings of 10 pixels for the menu background. Now let's open the T1093 block settings and configure the following parameters. Background blur, 10 pixels. Vertical alignment, I'll use the default top value. This parameter defines what part of the screen the pop-up block will be aligned to. Appear animation, appear from top. Animation easing, quote, easing out. Appear animation speed, 0.5 seconds. Let's check it out. The menu pops out from the top of the page while the background is blurred. Perfect. Let's discover another example with the second level menu. Go to the T1093 block settings and configure the following parameters. Background color, black. Background opacity, 40%. Appear animation, appear from top. Animation easing, quote, easing out. Appear animation speed, 0.6 seconds. Let's check what we've got here. You can see that the second level menu opens over the main menu. To fix it, you need to assign the right Z index. Open the zero block with the main menu. In the position and overflow option in the artboard settings, select overflow visible and specify the 99.99 value in the Z index field that will appear. Save the changes and go back to the T1093 block settings. Here in the Z index field, you need to specify a lower value, for instance, 9998. Save the changes and see how it works. You can use all the animated examples from the video in your project. Import these templates using their template IDs. You will find them in the video description, as well as the guide to importing templates. Share your ideas on how you're gonna use the new block. Like this video if you found it useful and subscribe to our channel. See you soon. Bye.